Assalamu alaikum, welcome to Cooking is Fun with Firdaus, back with another iftar special recipe, which is sweet and savory stuffed buns. These buns are very, very simple to make and very delicious. So let's begin. For this, we'll be needing all-purpose flour 1 cup and milk powder 1 teaspoon, sugar 1 teaspoon, activated yeast 1.5 teaspoon, and gently mix all these ingredients together. And then you can also use dry yeast if you want to. Here I'm adding warm water little by little to knead the dough and ensure that we need a nice stiff dough for the buns. We don't want a soggy dough, we need a stiff dough. Once the dough is made, drizzle some oil on the side of the bowl and just let it set aside. You can cling wrap it or dump it with a warm cloth and let it sit for about an hour to double it up. And after an hour, once it doubles up, we will knead the dough now. As you always know that I never knead the dough when we are actually kneading the dough. So once it's doubled up, it's then when I knead the dough, because this gives a very good a sponginess to your bread, to your buns. I'll show you how it works. So here we will knead the dough and then we'll start working on the dough. We'll divide the dough into two parts. Once it is divided, half part for savory, half part for sweet. Now this remaining half, we will divide the dough further into 8 equal parts. Both, you'll get 8 equal parts on in both the doughs. So once that is done, we'll first make the sweet buns. For sweet buns, I'm using cheese triangles as a stuff. So once I stuff in, I'll just roll it out into a nice smooth ball, and there you go, it's done. So like this, I'm going to do it with the remaining portions of. Once this is done, we will let this sit in the baking mold for about 15 to 20 minutes. Once it doubles up, we will give an egg wash and drizzle some sesame seed on it, and then we will bake this at 120 degrees Celsius for about 15 to 20 minutes. There you go, we give the egg wash, some sesame seeds, and bake. Moving on to the savory part, we'll be preparing the filling now. For filling, add 1 teaspoon of oil and ginger garlic paste. And then this mutton minced is actually marinated in tikka masala, so you can choose your own filling if you wanted to, but ensure the filling should be very dry and not liquid type. Now once the mince is cooked, we'll add chopped coriander leaves and half cup of peas to it, and once that is cooked, we'll let it cool down, and then we'll add this to a blender along with mozzarella cheese and some cut onion. And just give a small light blend to it, so it's coarsely blend, and then you add cheese triangles to it. Once you add the cheese triangles, once again you give a slight blend to the ingredients and ensure that it's not too pasty nor too coarse also. Once that is done, now we'll start making in our stuff balls. Now for this, as you can see, I'm going to stuff in to the dough and form a nice soft ball out of it. Ensure that you nicely tuck in the dough, because this is savory, so it needs to be firmly stuck in. So once it's tucked in, we can again give an egg wash to it and drizzle some sesame seeds on top and bake at 120 degrees Celsius. So once these buns are baked, you can give some butter wash to it, and then on the savory bun, you're going to pour about 2 to 3 teaspoons of condensed milk over it and serve it hot. Moving on to the savory, just give a butter wash to it on top for a nice fine glow on the buns, and then you can start serving them. There you go. It's too hot right now. It's come out right from the oven, and I'm trying to just to show to you guys. Have a look at it. Just look at the buns. They'll be very, very spongy and soft, just like how you find them in bakeries. Pretty and lovely. These buns were just amazing, and my children's, we just loved it. Okay guys, thanks for watching. I hope you will try this at home and share your thoughts and comment below. In the description box, I have given the ingredients list as well. Thank you. Happy fasting and stay blessed.